Come and see what he has done for us. Tell the world of his great love. Our God is a God who saves. Our God is a God who saves.
My favorite part is definitely living with people. That's what's kept me in it for going on 7 years now. I like sharing life with other people. So my desire has always been to work with students. What I really like about this job is that I not only get to work with them, but I get to be with them. I get to be in their territory, in their turf, and actually spend time with them in ways that I probably couldn't spend time with them as a youth pastor or as a counselor. So that is by far my favorite.
I think that Ryan is such a great guy to have as a mentor, as an RE. For me being an RA, he is very, caring, and he's always wanting to know what's going on in my life, always there for me if I have anything going on. So that's really encouraging that he is just, I know that he's always there for me no matter what.
Well, you know, before Ryan came to Mid-America, he was at KU. Doing the same type of thing. He was a resident director there. Plus, he'd gotten his master's in student development. So educationally and experience, he really had all that we were looking for. But it's much more than that. I think it was his heart and his real desire to be with students, to interact with students. So I'd say that was the biggest thing, is looking at his heart and knowing what he wanted and how he wanted to work with students and just help people grow.
Our God is a God. Our God is a God who saves.
I think his friendliness and his accepting nature, just the way that he, that he really cares about the people who are around him, and you can tell that. I think that's why, I think that's a great thing for him to have, just be able to really be able to accept and care for all the people around him.
Ryan has just a love of learning and education, and I think that's kind of infectious. I mean, I think it rubs off on other people, and they look at learning in a different way. You know, they think, oh, this maybe isn't drudgery as much as it's fun to learn as much as he can about a subject. So I would say that. I just think he has a love of learning in anything educational.
I am almost finished with my third. I have, at Mid-America, I got a Bachelor of Arts in Youth and Family Ministry. I have a Master of Science in Education from the University of Kansas. And I'm almost done with a Master of Arts in Theological Studies from Nazarene Theological Seminary. I came to college in 1997 here, graduated in 2001, was away for a year and a half. I've been here ever since. So in many ways, excluding my pre-college life, Mid-America is just about all I've known. So to answer that question is near about impossible, because I think it's impacted about every area of my life. It's been my life. This campus community, the people that I've done life with here for the past 7 years, and then 4 years before that, was just about everything I experienced. So,
this is Ryan's last year here. He's already told us that he's going to go find something, a new adventure, something fun to do now that he's finishing his second master's. Did I mention he loves learning? and I just think that we have just gained so much as a community from knowing Ryan and having him here on staff, and the stories that students tell about him and the stories that I hear from students about, I talked to Ryan about this issue or that issue and how he helped guide them. I just think it's going to be a really lasting impact, much beyond probably what he even realizes.
Well, I'm not exactly sure what the next step is for me. I'm called to ministry. I'm ordained. I've committed myself to the ministry for the rest of my life. I know that my desire is to always serve the Lord. And I refuse, Josh, I refuse to dictate that. I refuse to dictate that for the Lord and to lock myself into any particular form of ministry. If I could leave Mid-America and the students that I work with more of a passion for the Bible and getting to know God's Word, that would be great. That would be a victory for me. So if it's like 20 years from now, if it's the year 2028 and you're watching this video, know that back in the early 2000s when I worked here, I was the guy who was really passionate about the Scriptures. And hopefully my life reflects that. I hope it does.